The goal of this project was to look at what happens to patients who are hospitalized during the dates of national cardiology conferences. We initially thought that the outcomes of patients who had a cardiac arrest or heart attack or very high risk heart failure would actually be worse during the dates of these meetings because cardiologists would leave town to go to the meetings. But what we found was the complete opposite. It turns out that for two of the three acute cardiovascular conditions that we studied, mortality was dramatically lower among patients who were hospitalized during the dates of national cardiology conferences compared to just 2 or 3 days before that. And so then the question then is, why are we seeing this? Why is it that patients who have cardiac arrest on the date of a cardiology conference are less likely to die, much less likely to die, than a similar patient who has a cardiac arrest just 2 or 3 days before or after? First thing that we found is that these patients are nearly identical. So there is not this concern that patients are delaying care because their own cardiologist is out of town. Clinically, cardiac arrest isn't a condition that people can choose to have. When your heart stops, it stops. It's not like you choose to have your heart stop, right? And so in theory, we wouldn't even expect these patients to be different between the meeting dates and the non-meeting dates. And then the question then is, well, why is this happening? So it's not because these patients are different. So something different is happening in the hospital on those dates that is not happening on the non-meeting dates. And the question is, what is that? And we don't have a complete answer. We don't have a full answer, but we have some nuggets of information that can guide us along the way, and we have a little bit more work to go to finalize what's going on. I think a natural question is, what do you do with these findings? How should we change healthcare practice? And that's actually a very difficult question, in part because we don't have the full answer to why we are seeing these differences. One explanation is that less is more for certain patients, and for certain patients, doing more aggressive treatments can actually harm them. And I think pursuing a research agenda that attempts to explore what works in what patients and at what times is critical, and I think that type of research agenda follows from the findings of our study. And I think as an economist, my job is to try to bring economic insights, the tools that economists use to study behaviors and questions around us, and to take those types of tools and insights and try to understand questions like this in healthcare.